Starting learning C++ is easy. I did it when I was like 12. But there is a lot of information online, and there are some very important things that people don't talk about. So in this video, I will tell you the exact 4-step process that you need to follow in order to learn faster and get ahead of other people. So let's go. So the first thing you have to do is to understand what C++ is, and I will just cover that myself very quickly. So C++ is a programming language, and this means you write C++ code that gets converted into a computer program. Now the process of converting this C++ code into a program that runs on your computer is called compilation, and it is done by something called a compiler. And there are several compilers. Also, in order to make writing code easier, there are special text editors that come integrated with the compiler that also show you errors and help you in various ways. This is called an IDE. This might be a little confusing, so let's look at a simple example. So, you are not installing C++ in your computer. If you're on Windows, you'll probably install what is called Visual Studio IDE. This is a text editor that also comes with the Microsoft Visual Studio compiler. And this compiler knows how to compile your C++ code into a program. Okay, so in order to start learning C++, you need an IDE. But have a little patience. The second step is to choose a C++ tutorial to follow. There are a lot of tutorial series, so let me tell you a little secret. Every beginner tutorial is roughly the same. So don't spend too much time choosing what tutorial series to follow. And never pay money for a beginner's programming course. They are not worth it. Now, I will soon be making my own paid program, and you might say that I'm contradicting myself. But that thing will be different. It will be targeted to something very specific, game development. And you'll basically be paying me for my time there. But if you are still unsure, you can, for example, start with this tutorial series that I have found to be very nice. Now, whatever IDE the guy in the tutorial uses, that's the IDE you should use. Ideally, I think that Visual Studio is the best IDE for C++. Not Visual Studio Code, but Visual Studio. But you don't care about that now. Right now, you want to learn coding, and this is complicated enough. You don't want to make your life harder. So just use the same IDE that is used in the tutorial that you follow. Because most tutorials will also tell you how to get started with it. Now, step 3 is to exercise. And here comes a secret that few people talk about. You see, if you find yourself liking programming, you might be tempted to learn as much as possible about the language. But I think that it is more important to practice rather than get into more things. So I would say practice a little on your own, with every little thing that you learn, and also try CodeWars. This is a nice website where you can solve exercises. I will put on screen right now a list of things that you have to learn, and also things that you should know that they exist, but not necessarily use yourself. If you choose to use them later, that's fine, but for now, once you get through this list, you should go to step 4, and that is to start making big projects. The best way of learning programming is to make a full project, start to finish. It is 10 times better than solving exercises, and 100 times better than learning algorithms or learning weird things about the language. This is my Minecraft clone, made entirely in C++, and I have used mostly only basic C++ to make it, and no advanced algorithms. But I used a lot of my programming experience and thinking that you gain only by doing big stuff. So that's why I think that once you have a basic knowledge of C++, you should start making a nice project. And of course, you can always Google things that you don't know, and in this way, you will also learn new language features or algorithms. But you learn them using them in the real world, and I think this is more powerful. So what should your program be about? Choose something that you are passionate about. Be creative. You like F1 races? But a racing game is too difficult? Make a simple program that calculates some useful statistics. Heck, one of my first projects was a Five Nights at Freddy's clone that looks something like this. And nowadays, you can find online help for almost anything that you want to make. So search for it now. Now, if you like games and you'd like to make a C++ game, subscribe to this channel and return to this video for step 4, because I do game dev in C++, and this video is a step-by-step full easy guide to making your first C++ game. Plus, I think that you will find the things I do here interesting, and that they will keep you motivated. The bonus step is to join a community, to keep yourself motivated. But most importantly, to ask for help. I like asking for help, and I remember when I joined Cherno's Discord, it helped me a lot. But now I have my own Discord community, with helpful people, so come here, and you can even ask me things directly. So if you like this video, share it with a friend that wants to start programming, to help him. And also, check out some other videos from my channel. See you!